Hello there and welcome back to Strategic Command World War II, World at War, as we continue our fight for the French freedom. And we are awaiting the inevitable so far, and we'll see what the Germans will do in their February term. So let's see what happens. That's nice, although it does not affect the game in any way. Ooh, that's amazing. That's good news. We need those weapons fast. No bad weather on near the lower countries. Who knows what that might mean? Who knows? I just hope they will not take the advantage of this. But, well, if they do, good for them, I guess. And we'll deal with them anyway. That's actually amazing weather in February, as the ground isn't frozen in low countries. If it was me, I usually in my PBM games as Axis, I usually attack in February unless the ground is frozen. Then, like you can see in Germany and France mostly, then it's pretty bad to attack when the ground is frozen. But if not, it's mud. If it's mud or even rain or snow, like you can see in China, you can tear the low countries apart even without earth power. And usually you should be ready by February to do so. Just some information drop from me, but let's see what happens now, actually. And I believe that is the Deutschland, and it will be soon pretty gone. Well, that was a beautiful last sail, but what can you do if you try to sneak into Baltic like just like that? Yeah, keep doing that without HQ support. Just like that. Yeah, I'm going to cut him off. That's an amazing freeze, but okay, it's all right now. As I've said, I believe last time, it happened exactly what I predicted. So maybe in March we'll see some attack. Really? This is the wrong way, my friend, to move. A really wrong way. Well, I believe this is it. As the AI doesn't know what to deal with, how to deal with our advance in China. Well, perhaps next time it should not guard a key position with garrison which was unupgraded. Well, it happens. As long as they do not hurt our mine here, it doesn't hurt that much. And I believe they've changed it in one point with this newest patch that the Norway convoy does not become inactive, maybe. That would be surprising. Calculating supply. Oh, some kind of decision to make. Do you want it? In a normal game, I would say yes. But in this case, well, we actually might use those MPPs in defense of France, so I'm going to say no. Yep, that's nice, that's also nice, so let's put them straight away. In Marcel. We are upgraded, so we can move directly here. You, my friend, are going to travel to protect Lyon from paratroopers. And you're going to guard Tunis instead. Where is our third year garrison? Yeah. Oh, we can land him as well. Which is nice. Just the potential reserve to block them away. But let's take a look at China first. as their supply drops even further, but not yet enough to be an easy kill. Oh ho ho, we can deal damage. Now you're going to hurt a bit. Ah, that wasn't that great. That probably will kill it anyway. With a bit of luck. Well, with those kind of shots, not really, because it should be dead by now. And we can't really move him away, so we'll need to swap him instead. Yeah, shattered? No. Unfortunately, it survived. Two supply in Wuhan. Two supply. Can we really cut him off? Not, it doesn't look like it. But if we can hurt him, why not? Well, that's not exactly what I was hoping for. But you, can you move? Why can't you reach? Let's attack him instead. Maybe we'll cut him off actually. Though I'm not really sure how viable it is. Let's swap you. Nice hit. What's his supply one? Well, he will probably disappear next time. Just to make sure he'll suffer. And we've got a lot of points that we have. I'm not really sure we have much to spend it on, so we're going to spend it on command and control. And when it comes to control, let's see what the Ruskies have to do. Should always start from the unit most to the west, but they will not collide with each other anymore, as they have the same amount of moving points, except the special forces, which has 6 when forts marched. What is the closest? Yeah, doesn't really matter. I like this. And this as well. Not enough money to buy anything? Well, we could always... No, that's too extreme even for me. We are not going to buy anything with India, as we want to buy HQ, but with USA, we can invest into spying and intelligence at this point. And let's take a look at France first. Do you want our HQ in top shape? Definitely. And our court guarding Marcel is at full strength. We're going to upgrade you, reinforce you by 1 point. And we also have to start reinforcing our backup options here by 1 point each. Alright, let's take a look at British research. I want to... Yeah, next turn we'll have it by... For sure. I want to rush armored warfare as well, as we'll receive a tank via event. And let's do what we wanted to do. Attach our units. You can move here, and we are going after he's done doing his job, which will happen at the end of this turn, I believe. We are going to move him, move this anti-aircraft gun to protect those two units. And as you can see, we'll protect the entire line outside of the Maginot line with anti-aircraft guns, which is very nice. We actually have enough money to buy a corp, which we'll need, so we might actually do it. But I'm not going to do it, as we will need to upgrade him with infantry weapons anyway, which will take a turn. Which means that in the end it will come to the same conclusion if we buy him next turn. So, with this upgrade. So, what I'm going to do is to actually upgrade some of my ships around here. We're going to move. I'm going to upgrade even my destroyers, because why not? Yeah, I'm not going to invest into this tech, AA tech. Where are our subs? Do they have anything in here? Most likely. Great. And upgrade you as well. And you. And you are going to move closer to the front line, as will reinforce you. And move this HQ closer to the Italian front line as well. And of course we haven't switched the HQs in here, because it's not really necessary yet, I guess. to replace him with someone better. But we are going to do it next turn, maybe. 38 points. Let's move this guy. Maybe not. Actually, those guys need upgrades as well. And our other two ships here will use them to make a trap. One here, he can leave, really, without bumping into one or another. As the Italian destroyer will appear in Mogadishu. No, and I would also forget about you. Here you hide. Yeah, you dive. Run and hide. And of course, I would I was pretty close to forgetting about him completely. We're going to destroy him. Oh, that was unfortunate. That was really unfortunate. Let's hit him with a heavy hitter. That's nice. Nice amount of national morale points. Let's take a look. We are over the max, as you can see. French units, not really. They actually dropped a lot by 10% because of the fall of Poland. Chinese national morale 85%. Well, that's obvious. And we'll send you here to perhaps hijack the Graf Spee. Actually, should have moved you to a port where you can replenish to full. Okay. I guess that will be it for this turn. Maybe. Let's take a look. We are not ready yet, but we can transport you. Which we are going to do. But we need to have him in port to upgrade him, of course, as it only gives you 5 supply. But that will be actually it now. So, as usually, thank you for watching as we continue to fight to the last bullet to make sure that French remains independent. And I hope that you like it, and I hope to see you next time. So, thank you once more, and see you.